you know, and he was forced to apologize. I know him very well. He was forced to apologize because openly he told me that he said, I don't really listen to Sheikh Fawzan. I just use him against you because, like, I use the Bible against the Christians. But in front of camera, because he knows that if he said that openly, people will leave him. But he wants to hide. So the point here is that when you go back to following the Salaf, the book of the Salaf, is that you see clearly that many people are opposing it. And if you, okay, hang on. Yeah, hang on, if this guy is a claim Salafi, but that's why I tell you study. That's why I advise everyone, read and learn. Get also Sunnah Imam Ahmad al-Hanbal Shaybani, Shah Sunnah Imam al-Barbahari, Shah Sunnah Imam al-Muzani. You know, تكلم عربي ده؟
No.
تقرأ عربية؟
No.
Can you read it? Yeah, got these books, أخي.
Can I ask a follow-up question?
Yeah, تفضل, no problem. So I mean, I'm here for this. You're not going to take my time.
It sounds as if when we hear about it, that they want to make madakhila, the big difference is not in aqidah, but it's in khuruj. That's my understanding. That
they want what?
The big difference is in khuruj, whether you can do khuruj or not.
شو ما سأل يكنا دو خروج؟
I'm just saying that from my viewpoint, it sounds as if the big difference is not in the aqidah, but it's in khuruj, whether or not you can do it.
There's no madakhila. First, there's no madakhila. But even for the sake of argument, let's see, so-called madakhila, yeah? This Prophet Muhammad says in Hadith, books of the Salaf. That's why, you know, there was a guy who was dealing with him. And what he used to do, he became like Shi'i. He started, because you know Shia and Khawarij, they don't go back, when we differ in Aqidah, they go back to the book of history. And that's what the Shia exactly do. So that's why, who was the one who revived the Shia, not like the Khawarij? It was Abdullah ibn Saba. And from him, Shia came, and Khawarij. This was Shia and Khawarij, they're best friends. In private, you know, they pretend they, but they in private they're best friends. So, of course, yeah. And so the Shaykh Barakallahu Fik, the Salaf said that. I mean, not me. Prophet Muhammad said that. The books of Aqidah of the Salaf, clearly there's a chapter. And we don't know rebel against oppressive leader. Oppressive what? Leader. And by doing so, you're opposing the Athar. These individuals are mocking. And who said that? Ahmad Rahimah Ta'ala. Not because Imam Ahmed said it, not Imam Ahmed because he was an Imam in Sunnah, not Imam in Sunnah in part 8. You know, that's why I follow this Imam. You know, but now, because of the calamity of this social media, even there's some goodness in it, but majority is calamity. Now, anyone get YouTube, a phone, start opening channel and giving da'wah. Influencer. Influencer doesn't mean you give da'wah. You know, these so called influencers. He's clueless, never studied a book in his life, Aqidah of the Salaf, from the beginning to the end. You understand, okay? So again, what they're doing, they're attacking the Salaf, is just as, let me give you the good similitude. The Shia, what they say? They say, we don't have problem with the Sunnis, we have problem with the Wahhabis. But what do you mean by Wahhabis? Sunnis. But because they know the people that follow Sunnah correctly, so-called Wahhabis, they know Dubandis, Maturidis, Naqshbandis, Sufis, they don't follow no Sunnah, nothing. They're opposed, do you understand that?
Yeah.
So now it changed. We are against Madkhalis. In reality, against Salafis. You know? But they can't say we are against Madkhalis. So the deviated sect of our time, very similar to the Shia and who say we are against Wahhabis. We're not against Sunnis. So they say we're not against Salafis, we're against Madkhalis. Do you understand? And I challenged them many times, Akhi. I said, I've been challenged for a long time. And every time in the comment section, Shamsi, go learn English. Shamsi, go learn Arabic. Even though I speak Arabic, I speak English. Yeah. Shamsi, go learn French. He's like, well, how many languages do you want me to learn? You understand? So they forget the main point. He's telling me what to do. Because why? By Allah, no one can accept this challenge. Open the book of the Salaf. Show me the usul of the madakhila. We'll oppose the usul of the Salaf.
Your English is good, mashallah.
Huh? It's not that bad, alhamdulillah. I'm not eloquent in my English language, but it's enough for me to speak to my family and give da'wah to people. And by Allah, still they accept Islam.
Yeah.
Alhamdulillah, you understand?
Huh? They're
Athari
in
Aqidah.
Who's
Athari in Aqidah? Hijab, isn't he? No, abadan. Abadan.
Oh,
he's Ashqalida? He's Mutala'ib in Aqidah.
Okay.
You know, Akhi, would you bend this? Okay, if you're Athari in Aqidah, Dubandis will never love you. Because
yeah,
if you go misguided, you see?
Yeah.
So Dubandis, they love Muhammad Hijab because what? He's a hidden Ash'ari. He's a hidden Ash'ari.
Oh, so he doesn't claim to be.
He will not say, I'm appreciate I come from Athari background, yeah? He means I'm Kaddab. And I will stand before Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Because you know, calling brother Kadab is a big claim. And you know, whatever we're going to utter is going to be written down. You know, there are two angels now. You know, like one of the scholars said, not just two angels writing it down, it's been recorded too. Understand? أو stand for Allah, this man is كذاب. I couldn't believe how he's a كذاب. It's أخي. There's a video. They lied about me. Just to say one. He said Shamsi. حياك الله حبيبي. He said Shamsi. When he came out of prison, he started working for self application and they started paying him. Yeah. Muhammad Hijab, he was on the other side of the park. I told him, Muhammad, that's not true. I never worked in my life for Maktaba Salafiyya. Even when I go buy books from them, I have to pay them, man. They don't even get to give it to me for free. I have to pay. So he said, okay, I apologize. Guess what happened? Last week, he, because that's his channel, I don't want to even mention it. A channel that he used to spread garbage, yeah? He doesn't respect that channel, because I know who's behind it. But he's associated with it. He mentioned it clearly. In that channel, they re-uploaded the same lie, even though I clarified that to him. And many lies, accusing Maktaba Salafiyya, they took £1 million. No, where is the proof? No proof. Barakallah. Because why? He noticed that we studied and guessed his misguidance, alhamdulillah. So, akhi, read the book of the Salaf. That's my advice. And that's why I said, anyone who said that Madkhali is a sect, tell me their usul. And make sure the usul is not in the books of the Salaf. If there's a book of Salaf, so you are misguiding the Salafis, but you are giving them bad name to scare people away from them, just as your forefathers, Sufis, extremists, and Shi'is did, and Khawarij. Khawarij and Al-Jahmiyya. The Al-Jahmiyya, where they say Al-Sunnah, Mujassima. That's what Imam Ahmed said. If you hear someone say, so-and-so Mushabbih or Mujassim, then know he's a Jahmi. Yeah, subhanallah. So they give bad names. To or Hashawiyya. Hashawiyya mean they don't know, they don't understand. They are lowly people. So that is the same thing, but you know, كما يقول just تغيرت الفاظ. Terminology has been changed. And you know, the Khawarij, what they call it, these guys were, Ahl Bida, all of them, Ahl Bida, that's what the Salaf said. Ahl Bida, very similar to Munafiqun.
Would you classify Ash'ari as Bida
as well? Of course, they're not Ahl Sunnah. والجماعه
all of Ash'ari, so all of
Maghrib and you're talking about generally speaking now. Yeah. I was talking about the Awam who doesn't know.
No, Awam.
Yeah, the Awam, if doesn't know.
We
treat them differently. But the Awam, if doesn't know, I mean, even the Awam, to be honest, in our time, majority of times, they believe Allah is above the creation. Yeah. But because of what they call Ash'ari, they are Ahl Bid'ah, no doubt. Ash'ari, Maturidis, Dubandis. But they are Ahl Sunnah. In opposition to Shia.
I heard somebody said all three creeds are valid.
Who?
Hamza Yusuf.
Yeah, but which one? What do you mean?
You said the Athari, Maturidi, and
Dubandis. No, that's incorrect.
It's incorrect.
How? The Athari goes back to Quran and Sunnah, Dubandis, and other than them, they go back to philosophy.
Somebody listens to it, and I'm just saying it's wrong.
You know, so Ash'ari, Ahl Sunnah, Ahl Sunnah in opposition to Shia. Understand? It's called general ta'rif. But specific ta'rif, Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'a wal Hadith wal Athar, Salafiyun, akhi, you know, Ash'ari. Yeah. Like, is that clear?
Yeah, it is.
Read, akhi, wallah, read, alhamdulillah. That's why I advise people, read. And now there's a new movement, by the way, new movement of so called Salafis only on the paper. But in implementation, they don't follow no Salaf, nothing. He said, I agree, it's on the paper. I agree, I follow Athari. But in implementing the madhab, he's implementing something completely opposite. May Allah guide us and guide him.
Amen.
Afrika barak, shukr inshallah khoya. Barakallahu fik.